Morning all. Time for a little bit more work on the compressor set. All the glue's gone off now and it's all very very strong, gone together very nicely. So today we're going to try and mount the compressor, I think. Just check the clearance there. And you remember from the last video it was very close, the pulley, so I need to look at that. But I was thinking about this running on concrete. And whilst it's alright when it's ticking over, it won't go anywhere. I reckon that when it's thrashing away, doing some work, it might actually walk. The vibration will make it move about. And that could get quite irritating if you're trying to use it for some actual work. So, what I've thought, it needs some little rubber feet. So this morning, I found these little Meccano wheels. Well, I was going to use little door stoppers. The sort of thing you put on the skirting board to stop the door hitting them, but those will do just as well. So I mean, you shouldn't see them under there, it should be okay. So just going to try and put those on. That'll also help me when varnishing, it'll mean I can do both sides at once. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. Well, I've now solved the problem of the belt. Before it was, the pulley was to about there, and when I put the belt on, checked it to whereabouts it would be on a 80mm pulley, it was just going to be way too close, it would be rubbing and it would wear the timber away. So what I've done is just cut another couple of blocks and put them on top of the originals. Now, so that's what it looked like, quite high up now, which shouldn't be a problem. I have had to put this on here just to hold it, stop it falling over while I do the video, so don't worry about that. But I'll show you how I put these on. We've just got a couple of wood screws there. On the other blocks, which are screwed and glued as well, the screws are there, so we've had to miss those. But we should still be able to get a bolt through the middle. So I think that'll be okay. They're quite strong, there's no twist. And you notice I've over countersunk these. What I'm going to do is use some of this sawdust, mix it with glue, and then fill those in. You won't be able to see your screw heads then. Should look okay. So I'm just going to try that. Well, I've just put the presto valve on the pressure sprayer now, and it seems to be holding about 2 bar fine. Just had it up to 2.5 where the safety valve goes. So just put this little valve on the side. And it should mean I can put a pipe from a compressor in. So as long as there's enough power behind the compressor, it should be alright. I think it's going to be okay, holding pressure, so yeah, should be good. The homemade wood filler's in now, and it looks a bit naff at the moment, but it is fairly flat with the top of the surface, and once it's sanded over, it should be okay. Not quite dry, so I think I'll go and have lunch, and then when I come back it should be alright. Well, I've just spent about an hour cutting down this old clutch. Now originally it was about that big, but I've hacksawed off the rest of it, and I'm going to try and make this into a pulley. So I'm going to put it on the lathe and turn off this ridge, and I might just try and put a slight groove in this side, and then we can put a V-belt on it. So hopefully we'll get it running. I've just got this running standing on the rubber feet, and it seems alright. Got a bit of a little end knock every time it misfires, but when running on load it should be okay. You notice a bit of pipe on the exhaust, makes it really quiet. Doesn't melt that pipe, so it should be okay. So just lets it tick over nice, takes the fumes away as well. Anyway, so I'm going to have a go at making this little clutch, pulley rather, so I'll try and show you a bit of making that on the lathe. Well, there we have it, one belt pulley. I've turned off the rough edge, which was all over there, and just turned this down a bit because it was out of round. But, you know, that always seems to be the way these cast things are. I've just tried to sand some of the paint off, but gave up with that in the end. I'm just going to paint it anyway, but I'll get it on the engine first, maybe even try and get it driving the compressor today. Got a little Woodruff key for it, but no idea where it is, so I'll have to find that. Maybe make one, I don't know. And grub screw for it. So yeah, gonna try and get that on the engine now. Well, I'm just gonna try a little test run now. Compressor's bolted on, pulley's fitted, and I've made a belt fit just for the moment. So I'm gonna do a little test run. I can already see it moving the pressure gauge on the tank, so that's brilliant. Right, well, I've now altered the belt tension, and we should have a little less slip, just sitting on its rubber feet as well. So I'm going to just take it up to 2 bar pressure and see what happens. I'll just release the pressure and you'll hear the load release now. safety valve working on the compressor sprayer now. It's working really, really nice. So it's all going to come apart again now, and the pulley is going to be polished up and varnished. So we'll soon have this looking ship-shape fairly quick. Well, I hope you like that. I'm certainly very, very pleased with that. Well, there we are. I think that's a successful test run. Thanks for watching.